How'd you find
me? Shut up!
Prior to that, the cigarette-smoking man was kind of a dark figure who sort of lurked around in the shadows and didn't do much more than smoke cigarettes. I mean, he really didn't have much dialogue prior to that. And, you know, to be truthful with you, I didn't know if Bill Davis, you know, I didn't know. I mean, I later learned he was an incredible actor. He teaches acting, he has an acting school. But at that time, I didn't know anything. All I knew was he was a guy that we brought in to smoke cigarettes. So here we had this incredible scene where Mulder comes into the apartment with the gun to his head and basically, you know, he's going to blow him away because he's sure that he had to do something to do with Scully's disappearance. And Bill was fantastic.
There were two characters in The Cigarette-Smoking Man. There was the cigarette-smoking man played by the actor Bill Davis, and then there was the cigarette. And if you'll watch closely, again, this is Iota Rob Bowman, he knew that that cigarette was its own character. And the lighter could also become a character. And you could tell a story just by a little smoke in the foreground. You didn't even have to see Bill yet, right? And you knew, it was like the downbeat and Mark Snow had come in, you know? You knew something was... this was not going to be good because the cigarette smoke was there.
And he knew exactly when he did it. And he would do the first take, and he would take a puff, and he'd talk a bit, and then do the blowing out at a certain time. And the second take, I would be keeping track of the puffs when he'd puff. So cut, print, moving on, Helga, print, take 2 and 4. And I would go up to him and say, so we're printing take 2, and he'd go, when did I first puff? I'd tell him the word, and he would match himself perfectly.
He was the Darth Vader of the X-Files. Again, like all so many things on the X-Files, everything that was given birth seemed to be given birth for because it was an accident almost. And it, now suddenly this man who was nothing more than an extra leaning against a file cabinet became the lead villain in the show.